Hi guys, thanks so much for stopping by. So today I'm gonna be talking about Sweet 269. This is the cover. It looks pretty steamy, doesn't it? This is written by Christine Zolens, and if you haven't figured it out yet, I apologize. This is a book review. Usually I will give you information from goodreads.com, and I don't even know why I use the word usually, because I will be giving you information from goodreads.com. However, I just looked at it, and the information is pretty short. So this is gonna be tough for me to do, but we'll still go through it. So this is, again, written by Christine Zolens. The title of the book is Sweet 269. It is rated 3.88 at goodreads.com. I will go back to that rating later on because I just don't understand that rating, but you know, everybody has their own opinion and they're entitled to that. It says here, leave your inhibitions at the door and make your fantasies come true. 3 weeks and no rules, any fantasy, anything goes. Lexa Novak would like nothing better than to let go and finally experience it all. So when the opportunity arises to do that, sorry, I'm dyslexic, she can't refuse, won't refuse. But what happens when your fantasies become your realities? Find out when you enter Sweet 269. This was published back in September 25th, 2015. What I do know is I believe I got this book very recently, and I think, let's just say, if I got this book today, within 2-3 months of me purchasing it, I read it. So I don't remember when I purchased it, but I do remember it wasn't really that long after that I purchased it that I read it. So the genres this belong to in Goodreads is romance, contemporary erotica. Maybe a little bit. Funny, yes. I already said contemporary adult and new adult. There's a lot of power to this book, and I think it should be also like mystery in there, because there's this part of the story that is kind of a mystery kind of situation, and I'm not even gonna give it more words to describe it, because I feel like if it's not even given here, I feel like I'm gonna be that person that will give you a spoiler, and I just don't want to do that. So I did figure out the mystery around the middle of the book. I'm very proud of that. I'm like, yes, I know this is it. I know, I am 100% sure. I figured it out pretty quick. And if you do pay attention really well, you can figure it out the same time, maybe even sooner than that. Until it was actually stated about that there was a mystery involved, I kind of had an inkling that I kind of knew what the mystery was. Does that make any sense? I know I'm just kind of tiptoeing around it because I don't want to make it a spoiler. I kind of knew what the mystery was or what was behind all of it. But I didn't exactly know that it was a mystery to begin with. I just kind of thought, I believe this. And then it was really put into play and I'm like, it made me think a lot, and I kind of doubted myself. And I think because I doubted myself, I didn't figure it out. I really didn't believe myself in the beginning. I'm like, it's too obvious. No way. So because I doubted myself, I'm like, no, it can't be. But then as soon as it was like around the middle part, I definitely was like, no. I was really, really sure. I was really correct. This is really what's going to happen. And of course I was right. I have read a ton, quite a bit of Christine Zolens' books. So, anyway, there was a lot of, the description from Goodreads.com towards the book, it made it seem like when it started, it's just sex. That's how it really kind of like the description over here. That's how it really made it seem to me. However, when you read the book, it really isn't like that. I feel like there's so much more depth in the book and the characters as well. And it doesn't even give you more than just Lexa Novak. It doesn't even talk about James or Jameson. It doesn't talk about Sophia. It doesn't talk about... Forget it. I'm not even going to say more. But anyway, it doesn't talk about all the other characters in the book. And it just kind of feels like when you open the book and you start on the first page, it literally just feels like this is just going to be sex from beginning to end. It's not really the case. And I really did enjoy the book a lot. I wish the ending was not what it was. I wish there were like a few pages more just to kind of explain more in detail. Really? I'm like, no, this cannot be the end. And I'm like flipping over. Well, I can't physically flip it over because I don't have paperback, but I was flipping it over through my iPad and I'm like, no, no, this is not happening to me again. No, but it did. Of course it did. So, I was completely, attached to this book. This book was such an easy and very quick read. It made me very giddy. I laughed a lot. There were so many things in here that were just incredibly funny. I enjoyed Lexa is really, oh my gosh. She's a great character. She's like this kick-ass heroine, just kind of, I feel like a lot of people didn't give her a lot of credit, and even because of that, she kicked ass in her own way. I'm not gonna give out, I guess it's a spoiler for, you know, who's who and who the hero is and all that stuff. I'm not even gonna say that. Again, I enjoyed this a lot. I laughed a lot. There were times that, you know, made me really giddy and excited, and there's this awe moment and like, oh my gosh, you know. I really enjoyed this book. I wish the end was definitely more, even a page or two would be better. But you know, it is what it is. I do recommend this book. I give this a 2 thumbs up. I enjoy this a lot. I would give this an 8 out of 10 stars, 10 being the highest. I would really appreciate it if you guys have other recommendations of books that are similar to this content style of writing. Every single Christine Zolens book that I have read, I have thoroughly enjoyed it. Thoroughly. Some better than others, but I have thoroughly enjoyed it. So if you know any other author that, you know, has this kind of hold on you like she does with me, let me know down below, because I would love to know who that is and I would love to purchase these books. And if you guys want to chit chat and how you liked or disliked or enjoyed or how you reacted, if you did, to this book, I would love to hear from you guys, as I always do. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you guys again next time. Bye. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please hit the like button, subscribe button, and the bell so you'll be notified whenever I do upload a new video. Don't forget to expand the description box, because as much as possible, I always try to get coupons for you guys, discount codes, and other goodies like that. I also have my Twitter information, Instagram, Snapchat, and for business inquiries, I have my email there as well. Thank you guys, and I'll see you again next time. Bye.